All right, well, we've got some fun in store today. Ronald and Ronnie are going to get you behind the scenes of figuring out how we come up with topics. We're now entering season 3, and we're super appreciative to all of our fans. Thank you so much. And we're really pumped up to bring some great shows here to start in season 3.
That's right, Ronnie. Yeah, so I think one of the things we got to figure out is who is actually watching our show. Like, who are these people? So I know, Ronnie, you've been studying the analytics a little bit. I mean, what's been your take on, like, who's our audience?
Yeah, it's super funny. Like, when we started doing this, we were talking about who's going to watch this, if anybody. You know, now we've got almost 1 million views, thousands of subscribers, and, we just never really knew who and what was going to reach out. So as we started combing through the analytics, we thought younger males might resonate with us since we're a little bit wiser and we could give some intelligence. But what we have realized is actually don't get me wrong, that audience is liking us, but the biggest audience that we're seeing support is ladies. Now, it's not a strong majority, so don't get your ego all inflated here, Ronald, but there's definitely 65% of our viewers are women. Who'd have thought?
Well, you know, I don't know about that. I kind of wonder if it's more like middle-aged folks. Whoa. You know, I mean, the younger viewers. We thought they might watch us because we might be relatable. But I think it turns out I think a lot of the younger viewers just look at us as ancient, like we're older. And I think that's part of it, is that we think we're a lot younger than we really are. At least in my mind, I haven't matured past 12 years old. You're probably closer to like 10 or 11. But I wonder, like, what, where should we take our topics? Like, who's really going to watch these things going forward anyway?
So it's interesting you talk about that. Like, you're right. Like, some of our more popular videos, we didn't think we were going to be as popular. Like, if you think back, like think of some of our most popular videos that surprised us. Like, one of the ones that really stands out is blue cheese. That was a season 1 topic. And we were talking about, is blue cheese good to eat? You know, we talked about mold and we talked about all these things. And for whatever reason, people like it. Like, and we're no, farmers here. We don't have like a degree in cheesology or anything like that. We're just simply talking about a topic that people are interested in.
Well, yeah, let's think about that for a second. So, I think where the demographics are showing is that people kind of around our age group, kind of that middle age group, and they're just looking for feedback on these random topics about life. And to your point, so we've got more women than men that are watching. You know, maybe it is the male viewpoint that they're looking for. You know, it's pretty rare a couple guys will talk about these topics. You know, to your point about blue cheese or
white pants when you wear them. I mean, that's not a typical topic that two guys like us are going to cover, but it's still fun that we have an opinion. You know, another one that really surprised me was, gym etiquette or gym locker room etiquette. Like, I think what it really comes down to is the topics that we found to have the most success with are topics that a lot of people have on their mind, but nobody really talks about it. Like if you think about how the whole show started, we took things like how to put your toilet paper on the roll. Like, that's a thing. I've heard people talk about this, but nobody takes the time to actually talk about it.
Right. Well, I mean, anytime you have something naked, you catch all the people who are just looking for nude people online. So I think
bring that up. I was just talking about gym locker room etiquette.
Well, I gotta tell you that video is, I kind of wonder why we have so many views. And I think people stop when they realize that no one's actually going to be naked on that video. We have a PG show, but I think if we did more topics on like what life is like with having kids and being married for a number of years and like day-to-day stuff, just based on to your point about the demographics, I just wonder if like Dealing with teenagers or like picking colleges, or dealing with the logistics of just getting your kids to all the activities and all that kind of stuff that they're into nowadays. I mean, it's like, yeah, I don't know. I mean, what do you think, Ronnie?
I think it's great. I think topics like that are important. I think there's a ton of, viewers. Like if you think about the demographics, and obviously I joke with the female audience being the majority, that's just, feel good. But there's still a ton of males that watch our show. And I think to your point about everyday life, like even things, kids 100%, like scheduling, conflict, how to deal with all that. But even think of some of the more everyday things that you and I do, traveling. Like there's probably a whole series of shows of like getting through security that would be interesting to people. I mean, that is a, if you've not traveled in a while, getting through security is wow, like not for the faint of heart. You've got to be dialed in to not go crazy going through that.
Well, yeah, and if you don't do it, then there's a whole slew of people behind you
Yeah.
who are gonna be angry at you because you're not dialed in exactly how you get, because all the business travelers, you're trying to get from point A to point B as quickly as possible. It's ridiculous. That's a great topic.
Yeah, so why don't you pull up? So we just for everyone's sake, we have a shared sheet that Ronald and I have been keeping ideas and topics. But as we get into season three, I think the concept of getting through security is a really fun one that you and I could do. I think talking about managing kids' schedules. People talk about time management of their own time, but it's no longer your time. When you have kids, your time is like slotting in between the kids' activities, and I think that's a really interesting one. Didn't you tell me about a story recently where you landed at an airport near your house and you decided to drive instead of fly or something like that?
Well, let me take some of these things down. So like going through TSA security. All right, so I'll get that one down. TSA security as a topic. And what was the other one, Ronnie, you mentioned?
Scheduling around your kids' activities.
Scheduling kids activity. That actually spurred on another idea. This whole idea of parents are chauffeurs now. Like kids don't
Totally.
even want to learn to drive or get their license because they're just used to parents driving them everywhere. Like I don't understand that. Like you and I, we got our licenses the day
Gone.
we turned 16.
Yeah.
But then now, like I just don't get it with kids. You know, I had to really like prod my eldest kid. Like ultimately, she got her license at like 16 and a half or something like that. I just didn't understand, what's the, don't they understand the freedom when you're able to get to places on your own without your parents, like, on top of you?
So this is a great topic. Actually, you're bringing up something that's making me, so write that down about getting a license. But you know what you're just making me think of? Like, think back when we were a kid, we had to leave the house to have freedom. Now kids can get lost in the virtual world. They can get lost in their phones. They can get lost in social media. They can escape without actually having to go anywhere. And so maybe the drive for leaving, because we used to leave so that we could connect with people, but nowadays you don't have to do that. You can connect with them on FaceTime. You can connect with them, through social media. So you can leave without leaving. I like
Social
that.
media as an escape instead of driving away from your family. That's a good
Yeah.
one. Here's another one. You know the apps that like track your family so like they you know exactly where your family members
Totally.
are at all
Yes.
times. So to me, like as a parent, that's a no-brainer. You have to get an app on your phones for your kids to know where they are. But you know, like with my kids, I mean, they feel like we're stalking them. But and here's the truth: if I was a teenager and I had a phone and my parents were on there, I would be thinking the same thing. That it'd
Yeah,
feel like
but
they're stalking me. Because to your point, it's like it used to be an escape. Like you could like drive away
right.
and you had this feeling like you are finally free, even though you got to be back home by a certain time at night. But you were free from
Right.
your family. But if you think about it from the kids' point of view nowadays, you are never free.
Yeah, so
They're
that's
always looking at where you are. And I mean, I haven't said this to my kid, but I get it. It's like,
right.
that's intrusive.
What if we did? I love the show idea. So from a parent side of view, 100%. Like if we know where you're at, then we don't have to call you and bother you. So we're giving you freedom by knowing where you're at, so we don't have to ask you. I get that, but you're right. We should bring some kids in for that episode. I think that's a great one. And we should talk to some teenagers and get their point of view, because you're right. We don't think about this from their perspective. And I could see how it would be like, okay, when do I ever get to just be me without you?
Yeah. You know, they call it stalker apps. It's like, you know, come on. I mean, I'm doing the same thing. Everybody knows where I am at all times, but I guess, you know, I hadn't really thought about this. I'm glad we're doing this, because it does feel like you don't have that kind of freedom. And where it came from is you're this idea, like social media is this escape where you're out in this world and your parents, right, no one else except, you know, other people on the social media and like are tracking you. But that was our escape when we were kids.
Totally. And
our driver's license to like go. And ultimately the parents didn't know.
Yeah. Didn't know. You know what that makes me remind me of? There's an app that my internet service provider has that I can track what websites they're using from their, you know, if they're on the network in the house. And my son was telling me, he's like, you know, that's about to get kicked off of the app store. And I said, what are you talking about? And he was telling me that there's like this big movement amongst kids to give it a 1-star review. And I guess on the app store, if you have lower rating than, you know, I don't know what the number is called, 1.5, that the app will get kicked off. So the kids are all banding together to download the app to give it a 1-star review so that parents can't download it.
Oh no, man, that's smart. I mean, based on the real like strong negative feelings that Sophia, my 16 and a half year old, has towards these stalker apps, where it's just like keeping families knowing where each other are at any one time. I could see that. I could totally see how the kids could figure out how to game the system.
Yeah. All right, write that one down. I like that. So when to use, I don't want to call it a stalker app because that makes it sound like a stalker. Because from our perspective,
that's what they call it though.
Yeah, but that's not what we call it. We call it, you know, peace of mind apps.
Right, right. Yes.
I like that. You know, another idea, this may not be one that has a broad appeal, but you know, for viewers that don't know, my wife is British and we were back visiting her family. And we had some lost luggage, which was a disaster. And I'd love to share that story about lost luggage. But one thing I learned about Europe is they put their baggage claim inside security. And in America, we put it on the outside of security. And so getting and retrieving your bags once they're found is not easy because you got to get through security. So talking about the different things that happen in Europe versus America when it relates to travel, I think could be interesting. I think we have a small audience, so it might not be something we want to do, but I think it's an experience and there's strong opinions about it. I mean, there were 50, 60 people in every line that I was trying to get into about this lost luggage.
Well, yeah, I think it applies all over the place. Like it's just been ridiculous with travel. I think a topic about how travel used to be like a luxury and something that you could really look forward to. And now it's just a drag. I mean, you think about even you take a week long vacation, but then you got to plan the first day. I mean, just figuring out how to get there and then planning that you're going to be late and what are you going to do if you're late? And then you got to pack things in your carry on or just like, even if you're driving with traffic or, I mean, it doesn't matter. Nowadays, it just seems like travel is such a drag. And then at the back end of the trip, it's like unpacking and cleaning all your stuff. It used to be like vacations were like this breath of fresh air in your life. You could just relax. And now it's been, and maybe it's just the flood of travel this year and things are going to calm down and it's going to get easier. But, you know, I'm not one to do like staycations. Like, because I just want to get out of the home element and, you know, I just kind of go someplace different, but, you know, making vacations simpler. But, you know, it's back to the kids though. You know, the kids are used to like going someplace and a hotel and, you know, and all the kind of vacation activities, beach or mountains or whatever it is. But, I kind of like, how do you make vacations simpler? I think that would resonate with kind of that middle-aged, you know, mom crowd, like trying
to dads. I mean, yeah. Often the dads are the logistics, you know, coordinators, and at least in my house, but yeah, I think I like that topic. You know, another, you know, so, okay. So we got kids, we got travel, we got scheduling. What's another area that we haven't talked about that I think would be interesting?
Well, we try to, you know, we try to stay PG, but what about when should you have that, you know, birds and the bees talk with your kids?
Yes.
because, you know, I mean, back in our day, I mean, I'm not sure parents did the birds and bees, the bees talk, but now it seems like it's something you got to do. There's books about it and everything. Actually, I don't know if you remember when our kids were super little, your eldest is really older than my eldest. And so you're a little out in front. So it was like, I was like pinging you, asking you like, yeah. What books did you, and then what ages to read these books? It's just crazy. You still have those books, by the way.
Yeah, I totally have those books. I think that's a great topic. So I think, you know, one of the things that would be super helpful, and we've never done this before, but let's ask our viewers. Like, I mean, I know this is a different format than what they're used to seeing us in, but let's put this up on our channel. Yeah. And save this. And if you're watching and you have some ideas, I think Ronald and I would love to, you know, again, we find some pretty creative ways to show our topics, but we'd love to know what topics you guys would like to hear about. I mean, we do some serious research. We dig deep into these topics and what's on your mind?
Like, yeah, 100%. Would love to hear from folks, you know, subscribers or just new people who found our show. Please let us know what you want to hear about. We'd love it, and then we'll make those shows, no doubt about it. If you share your ideas, we'll figure out how to get those shows done.
Yeah, don't feel like you have to put guardrails. Ronald and I are pretty crafty on trying to dig. So if you got something that's fairly obscure but you think will resonate with a broad audience, we're down. Like we'll figure it out. We'll become experts.
Yep. So, man, with that, Ronnie, I don't know. What do you think? Do you think we've gotten this episode fairly wrapped up? Our first, attempt at a Zoom show.
Yeah, I think we've got two or three episodes out of this that we can shoot. I'd like to spend a few more sessions, you know, and Ronald and I will do this. We'll go back and forth on some sessions to figure out, you know, we usually shoot videos anywhere from, you know, 5 to 10, you know, over a period of time. But I think we got three out of this that I feel pretty good about. There's a couple that I think we need to flesh out a little bit further, but yeah. What are you doing next weekend? You want to do another one?
Let's do it. Well, you know, once again, thank you so much to our subscribers. You know, we're building them every single month, and yeah, we're excited. We're excited, especially to get your feedback on new episode opportunities.
Yeah, absolutely. Thanks again, and catch you guys later.
All right, see you later, Ronnie.
See you, Ronald.